come to my HMD round or square table. Behind you, you see HTC Vive, Oculus Rift CV1. In front of you, you see Google Glass, the ST1080, and the Avegant Glyph, which I'm going to test further just now in the presence of this illustrious company. So what we're doing here is playing PlayStation 4 games over Wi-Fi using PlayStation Remote Play on a PC or a Mac in this case, running Windows 10. And that is the glyph we're going to play on. So let's see what happens. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about these HMDs while I play. Probably a good idea if I turn this down. What I can't show you is how razor sharp this display is compared to all the other displays you see on this table. Glass, of course, is a tiny screen, an AR screen. The ST1080 is a true 1080p telecast screen. The Rift behind you and the HTC Vive have larger fields of view, but they have a screen door and they will have ventilation when you use them. Of all of these, this is the most stunning image you could get, and I'm actually streaming it, which is another thing to take into account if I was just connecting it to the PS4 and maybe even sharper. But I'm not seeing any artifacts or pixels or screen door. And you can play anything you want. See what happens when BB-8 sees some Star Wars. All these HMDs, this one and this one, are the one you can use to play anything you want. I'll tell you a little bit more about that one if I get it. Why are we playing this old PS2 game? Because we want to show we can play anything you want. All your decades of games that you've collected don't go to waste. Now, you're going to have PlayStation VR as well, but you're not always going to be able to cart it around, are you? So, ease of use. You have to build a room for that thing, and you're going to need help. I'm still building room. Can't wait to use them.
Sixer, are you still with us? We're right below you, Ned. Good. Sol Sixer, Captain Orsai, you copy?
This is Captain Orsai. I just received a crash course in demolitions, and I'm ready to go.
This is Sol Sixer in demolition boat 2.
One of you needs to get into that sensor station and set your charges. Use your underwater escape pod if things get ugly.
So, over here we have a HMD that has no display. There's no display. There are 2 million small micromirrors projecting light into your eye, which is really cool. So this is evolution in HMD design. Behind you, on the Vive and Rift, you've got FOV to go VR HMDs, which are basically two slabs of phones stuck together, which is the evolution from one slab of the previous generation. If you're good with that, you're good with that. You've got better full sense, full room tracking with the HTC Vive, but I can do that with any of these as well, with the right sensors, and I have done, and I can do without wires as well. So, we're at an interesting stage in HMD evolution. Something like this is actually the future. Still more advanced than any of these, because if I turned it on, you could actually see through it. So this is an MR HMD. This one will give you a 100-inch screen and true 1080p. I use just eye sight tracking with it. So, what can we say? I can play a little bit more. What have I learned about it? Glyph, as I've been playing with it. The sound is stunning. It's the best sound on any HMD because it is a pair of decent headphones connected to HMD. I've been listening to all. Mostly Prince this week with it, obviously, and it is the best sound you can get in HMD. This does have head tracking according to the manual. You can turn it on and use it in jaunt VR for the moment, and when we get to the head tracking protocols, I'm sure we can start messing with emulating mouse and other stuff so we can get it. Rudimentary head tracking in first person games on PC and stuff like that. What else do you have to say? Glass is also something that has a really good future. You've been told a lot of stories about it. And it's mostly American PR gone wrong, but it's such a useful device. And it's 50 grams for God's sake. And that's an entire computer in 50 grams. Stunning. Behind you, say, let's get the lift. I've had these things, the Rift and the Vive, now for 4 weeks, and I've barely unboxed them because I've been so busy doing other stuff. Because playing stuff on these things is not the fun. Creating stuff is, and that's what I'm going to be doing, so that's why I'm not jumping up and down in a shop selling goods or cooking stuff or back in my old Valkyrie spacecraft, because I've done all that. And that's the thing, we've had around 4 years exposure to those HMDs behind you, and 4 years is a long time in tech for something to come out. And when it's come out, it basically leeches an entire PC and gets it to run software at a state that we were running it in 2008. So there's a mass audience for HMDs that are not like the ones behind you, but are like the ones in front of you, which can have multiple uses, MR and AR. Media, connect to anything, play on anything. Actually, POV, camera use, social media, without reaching for your phone. Really, it's very useful. So, you can do BB-8 messing around. There's a 3K laptop sitting behind you. And I know for a fact that the Vive can't work with it. And haven't dared try to Rift on it, but I can play anything I like on these HMDs connected to that And it is only a matter of time before the field of view and the optics on these things supersede those obsolete designs now behind you. So, that's not being radical. I firmly believe that if HTC and Oculus want to survive into the next second phase of HMD design, they have to ditch the FOV to go VR. Because it's going to go nowhere. The only thing they can do is stick two 4K phones together in those displays and then ask you to upgrade PCs to an extremely high level to run the same shop demo in a year's time, or 2 years' time, or 3 years' time. And in the meantime, we do have mobile VR and mobile MR and stuff like HoloLens coming. My HoloLens coming soon, hopefully. And I'll say to you again, like I said back in 2012 when I was going for this Kickstarter thing because of Carmack, his QuakeCon speech, that this HMD is still more powerful and versatile and useful than all of the ones that would come out. And that's because of versatility being designed into it. At the moment, the Vive and the Rift have teething problems. The Rift has supply problems, setup problems. The Vive definitely has setup problems. Their customer care must be going 24 hours a day, helping people set those things up with base stations. The software is not there, and I'll say it again, VR, HMDs, any kind of HMD is not going to succeed if you have to go through a walled garden app to log on, go into it. Look at the confusion at the moment between Vive and HTC. You buy a game on Steam, does it work on your Rift? Does it work on your Vive? Does it only work on your Rift? Does it only work on your Vive? That is BS. We live in an age where those PlayStation games are being streamed to my PC, my Mac, which is running Windows 10, which is streaming PlayStation 4. So there's nowhere on earth Oculus or HTC will succeed if they keep trying to go exclusive routes and keep those walled gardens up. Because people want plug and play. And plug and play HMDs have failed in the past. Walled garden ones cannot succeed where others have failed. Not until someone like Apple turns up. Which is something which looks good and works, and it's very expensive, but we buy anyway. But, okay. That was enough of the propaganda. Now let's get back to a little bit more playing around. What else have I discovered? You know, that is the mute. This is a 3D for SBS. I've only started experimenting with 3D at the moment. And this is for the head tracker, the 360, which allegedly only works with Jaunt VR at the moment, but the hardware is in there. So if the hardware is in there, then the application can support it like any other head tracking. Then it will get head tracking and everything. But right now, let's say I want to play these PlayStation games. I have, or my Xbox games, I have several different ways of doing that. On a screen, which is far more comfortable, and sound, which is far better than a large screen TV, or the screen door or the screen mesh that you get with FOV to go VR, HMDs, or Google Cardboard if you've not been caught out by buying those things behind you. So, I have a lot more to say on all these HMDs, but it's interesting to look at all the different HMD designs, and you're doing it in VR now, or pseudo VR, 360, what passes for VR. Not that there is any such thing as VR, VR is only one application for HMDs. So, are we at the beginning of a home computer revolution? No, not for VR, not for HMDs yet. There are no standards yet, there are no mass consumer devices yet. I think I'm a very lucky person to have all these things on my desk here. I doubt there's one person on the planet that has this same configuration at home of HMDs, including Mr. Lucky. And that's a problem. when the home computer revolution launched, we could walk into what you call Best Buy now, W.H. Smith, we could pick up stuff, pick up a computer, pick it up for something reasonable, plug it into a normal TV, not a 3K PC, or have to build a room for it like the Vive. And now, I have the Vive and I have the Rift. What do I do now? Which one is going to win? Someone has to lose in those FOV to go VR wars, and then we get to a standard. Or they all merge and we come on. That's another thing that can happen. And it didn't happen in the computer, home computer revolution, but we are too early to compare these things to a home computer revolution. There is a one for VR. There's a lot of publicity and PR and tagging and promotion. I've been involved in some of it for several years. But we're not at home computer revolution stage yet. But it is exciting, and I'm pretty certain that HMDs have already evolved past the retail releases of these things behind you. And we've got far more exciting things coming around the corner with HoloLens, with upgrades of this, upgrades of these things, Cast AR, Meta, Atia, Air. And also, did I say HoloLens? Probably forgetting. And some mysterious Magic Leap stuff, but by the time they actually release that, there'll be something better than that anyway. And that's the thing. The timing. Everyone is coming to market with something different. Different applications, ridiculous setup routines, ridiculous costs, or supply demands, something that's way ahead of its time or too exotic, or something that's been marketed by giving it to your ex-girlfriend and she messes up the marketing. Or you do yourself by marketing it out of reach of the average person. So all this is good, because the market is ripe for someone to come in and build something, design something, learning from the problems all these guys have had, and have a lot of fun in the meantime messing around with them. So enough serious stuff, let's play. Play a PlayStation 4 game on a HMD, which is a headphone set with no display, on an Apple Mac Pro running Windows 10, which I'm filming in 360, which you can watch in Google Cardboard or on your HTC Vive, Oculus Rift, ST1080, Glyph. Yeah, you can probably watch it on your glass too. Welcome to the future. Excuse me. While I have some fun.
A good ranger is always mindful of their surroundings. Hop across these moving platforms. Good job. You could be the recruit we've been looking for. Keep moving to the next part of the course.
And my specialty is brute force. Let's see how well you can bash these crates.
Look, up here. We see Captain Force.
Hey, that was pretty good. Keep moving. It's time to get our hands on some firepower. Go ahead and grab a fusion grenade glove from this Gadgetron vendor.
Of ammunition left sitting around in crates. Whenever my life is in jeopardy, I think of one simple guideline. Try not to die. I find that keeping this in my mind's brain helps me remember that in order to spice things up, we've armed these dummies with Gadgetron flamethrowers. I'm a lawyer. Cool.
Ladies and gentlemen, the savior of Solana.